sushi.
Self-sufficient in their own life. So, right now, when I'm talking to you, I feel like, you know, a lot of people up here can get kind of nervous. You know, it's easy to get nervous when you're talking to a whole bunch of people. So, what I want to say is, everybody in this room has their own talents, has their own passions, things that they can do. Now you might be nervous to showcase those talents in front of people and let people know what you're capable of, but I just want to let y'all know that everything that you're passionate about, you can use in your life. You might think maybe you gotta settle for less and just work that many diamonds or something, but all y'all can be your own bosses. So yeah, that's a little bit about me. And what I want to ask y'all is, y'all know it's Black History Month. So who do y'all think of when y'all hear Black History? Any people? He said Malcolm X. I think I heard Martin Luther King from somebody too. And Rosa Parks, Harriet Tubman, Frederick Douglass, Obama. Let's give a hand for Obama. All right. So obviously, it's a lot of people who immediately come to mind when we think of Black history. Martin Luther King, Rosa Parks, Malcolm X. But there are a lot of people and a lot of situations they don't talk about in the history books or in school. It seems as though we're still getting the same thing over and over each year. They don't talk to us about people like Angela Davis and Claudette Colvin. So I'm having a sixth grader right now talk to y'all about who Claudette Colvin is.
I'm in middle school, my first year of middle school, and it's Black History Month, and when we get to middle school, that's when they decide that it's time for us to learn one more person in Black history. So, y'all know Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, the top five people that they taught us about for the past all of our life in school. And Claudette Colvin was somebody, who knows Claudia Coleman? Who knows Rosa Parks? All right, well, what people don't know is Rosa Parks was actually the second person to refuse to give up her seat. And Claudia Coleman was a 14-year-old girl, teenager, like my brother, like some of you in here, and someone wanted to take her seat, and she refused. So she got arrested, and she was in jail as a 14-year-old girl. And then Martin Luther King comes through, you know, and he's like, I respect what you did, but I don't think you're right for what Rosa Parks did, basically. So Rosa Parks was chosen to be the person to refuse to give up her seat. Claudia Coleman is a story that most of us don't know, and it's because they don't want to put that out there, but I just learned this as a sixth grader. For years in elementary school, I learned Malcolm X every year, learned Martin Luther King every year, and they give us this one person to, you know, think about. Like last year, we learned about a white person for Black History Month. It was great. It was great. But even now, they talked about Claudia Coleman, and then got Maya Angelou and John Lewis. John Lewis is someone we don't learn about in school. Now we do. But yeah, that's all I got to say.
So yeah, obviously, like she said, there's a lot of people that we don't learn about in school. Constantly hear about slavery and us getting out civil rights, and that's it. But we know that it's a lot more that goes into Black history. Our daily life is Black history. Like, it's not just people right here or some people up here, all of y'all contribute to Black history at this moment. How many of y'all got Netflix?
I watch Netflix.
That's a lot of people.
I finished all the shows.
So there's this documentary on Netflix called The 13th. How many of y'all have seen that already? So that's only like 3-4 people, maybe 5. And what the 13th talks about is, you guys know about slavery and us being freed after that. But with the 13th Amendment, it said to have freed us from slavery, period. But there's some technicalities in that. Because in the 13th Amendment, it says there shouldn't be any involuntary or voluntary slavery unless they commit a crime. So all of these kids, all of these young Black kids who are going to jail for minor things like a little bit of a drug and going to jail for years for it, they're basically using all of them to get more money. Why do you think all of the jails are getting bigger and bigger? And they keep putting money into making jails and putting people in them, you know? So it's a really good documentary, and it talks a lot about Black history that we don't learn about in school. So I would challenge all of you, not just Black people, not just brown people, everybody in this room, to look at that and look more into Black history and things that you don't really see in textbooks. So, yeah, you guys know that a lot of things we do in our daily life is popular American culture. That's why we came out to Poison and Juju on that beat. Those two are very popular songs. Poison came out before a lot of us was even born, you know what I'm saying? But it's still a popular song in American culture. It is Black culture, but it's still something that all of us, well, maybe not all, but most of us know, especially Juju on that beat, because a lot of y'all turned up to that. I appreciate that. So, how many of y'all got some favorite music artists or actors or anybody in that type of field that you really like and that inspire you?
Chief Keef, Gucci.
Bryson Tiller. I mean, do y'all know who Bryson Tiller is? Y'all know Dome? The song Dome and Sorry Not Sorry, things like that. Yeah, you wanna sing real quick? Real quick? Just a little bit. People don't know.
What?
Dome.
But so Bryson Tiller is a very popular artist, very popular black artist. And you know, obviously there are way more people like Kendrick Lamar and name a rapper.
Schoolboy Q.
A whole bunch of people who are very popular people in our culture that not only one race listens to, but history, black culture is American history and American culture. So, me personally, I really like J. Cole. J. Cole is really relatable to me. How many of y'all know who J. Cole is? I like that. See, J. Cole puts his background in his music, he puts some substance in it, and his music is very relatable, and it gives the point of view of the kids who are less fortunate, or other kids who are misunderstood by the system. So that's somebody that I really like, and his album just went gold, so I mean, he's obviously a very popular person. So, simply, everything that y'all see around us, the popular music artists, the clothes, I'm gonna wrap it up by saying, all of you guys have the opportunity now to shape the way our future is gonna be. All of you guys have the power to change things that you see as bad in our world right now, and also to make improvements in our world right now. All of you guys will go down as our history. And you see it all the time. Like I just said, it's a lot of popular things that come from black culture that people